My name is Tim Wilkinson. I'm here today as an instructor for Local 46 for the apprentices that are coming in today. When I was in grade 10, we had a career studies. It said, pick a career and go for it. My father was a police officer for the City of Toronto. I always kind of wanted to be a cop, and I thought, you know, you get back to society. And it was something I really wanted to do, but I wasn't there yet. I was only in grade 10. So funny enough, I did my project on plumbing. When I got out of high school, I didn't really want to do university yet. I was set up to go to University of Toronto. I didn't want to do it. I looked at doing other aspects. I got myself into the Ministry of Transportation. Then I worked at Dyson Canada, the vacuum company. Then I worked at, you know, Canadian Tire Factory, and I said, you know what, I want to get a skill behind me. I worked at Home Depot for a little while. I was trying to find my niche, find a place to get into. I got into plumbing. I enjoyed the plumbing aspect, and I tried to get a job as a plumber. I met a handy worker. We had a little company business going as kind of renovations and bathroom renos. Eventually, I got myself into the union. I did the aptitude test, got myself worked out there. From the union, I got a job in a high-rise company. I was organizing fittings. Home Depot helped me out with that because I knew what some stuff was. From there, I got into night school. I started taking night school classes, started doing everything else. I did my basic level of Humber College. They said, hey, you're pretty good at that. Why don't you try out for a competition? I was like, sure, why not? I got nothing to lose. And I show up, and it was in Cambridge at the time. I show up and there's tons of cars. I had no clue where I was going, what I was doing. So I'm late for this thing, there's panic going on, there's everything else happening. We had to set up, at that time it was a totem pole. It was a plumbing totem pole of plumbing fittings, black fittings, copper. Some of the stuff I've worked with, some of the stuff I never did. And so I started tinkering with it, playing with it. I had a good concept of most of the stuff, but I was at a high-rise company, mostly commercial grade stuff, not really residential. The project we had ABS, had copper, had black steel. You had to do some bends in it. You had to position everything to a certain order. So I ended up fixing up some of the copper, making the letters facing. I finished my project on time. Surprisingly, it was a hard day. I didn't place any metals, I didn't place anything, but it gave me an introduction to an atmosphere that I've never seen before. And Humber got me in doing it for Humber. So when I went back to school for Humber for my intermediate, I got an opportunity to go again for Skills Ontario in 2014. Now I was able to be prepared. I knew what to expect. I knew kind of what to look for. So I faced my pipe, I faced my fittings. I had everything done up nice. And the best thing was, it was a three-piece rough-in. I did that every day. So I kind of knew what to do, where to do, how to cut it, how to make it work. I actually finished my project about an hour and a half early that I was able to make everything nice and clean, and I placed bronze. It was a great experience. From that experience at Skills Ontario, I was able to kind of hone in on my skills, like kind of perfect stuff, make stuff look nice. So when I went back to work, I ended up doing a better job, kind of got noticed, ran a little more jobs. I finished my apprenticeship up at Humber. I started doing a lot of extra stuff at my UA Local 46. Office, and I started doing backflow, which is what's behind me here. And during this time, I met the teacher, landed a job with City of Toronto, and I found my niche in plumbing. There's a lot of different things in plumbing. Backflow seemed to be my niche where I kind of escalated and excelled. So then I ended up coming on as a teacher, and I started instructing backflow. So today I am an instructor where I get to teach the youth of today, and I get to show them the right way, the positive way, the right attitudes towards it. Skills Ontario helped me to get to where I am today by showing me the right ways of doing it, by throwing me into a field of stuff that I didn't know and making me pick out the best aspects of it. Without Skills Ontario, I don't know if I would have honed in on that specific identity of like facing my pipes. I would recommend it to someone that wants to get into plumbing, because to me, it's been a life-changing career for me that I now own a house, I have a future, I have a family. Without plumbing, that never would have happened for me. So the demand of plumbing is there, and it will always be there. If you get yourself into different niches, whether it be new construction service, renovations, you'll always need a plumber to do something. You have to like the job that you get into. You have to like your career. And if you get into plumbing, make it a career. Don't just make it a job. Put some passion into it. Make sure that you make everything look the best it can be and do your best at doing your job. Because at the end of the day, that's who you are. That's what you leave behind.